क्लास का एट नाइन्थ में सेवेंथ है। मेरा नोटिफिकेशन गया कि देखा
गुड आफ्टरनून वेट फॉर टू मिनट्स विल स्टार्ट कैन यू हियर माय वॉइस My voice is audible to you? Yes, my voice is audible to you?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, just wait for 2 minutes. No one has joined still.
Yes, ma'am.
The screen is visible to you.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Okay, students, so let's start.
Only 4 people have joined.
It's already 1 o'clock, so we'll start. Okay.
Yeah, ma'am.
Okay. So, as you have the computer subject today. All of you know what is the definition of computer? Yes, anyone? Can you tell me what is the definition of computer? Yes, anyone? I'm asking the simple question, what is the definition of computer? From 1st to 6th standard, you're learning this computer subject. So what is the definition of computer, students? Okay, so let's start. For your 7th standard, you have completely 11 chapters. Okay, so today we will start your chapter 1 and the name of chapter is computer fundamentals. So before going to start your computer fundamentals, first, what is the definition of computer? So the computer is an electronic machine. Okay. So here in this computer fundamentals, we'll going to learn today. That is different learning objectives. That is classification of computer languages, binary number system, classification of computer software, and open source initiative. So in this, we'll going to learn these all are different topics. So before that, I'll tell you what is the definition of computer. So the computer is an electronic machine. As you know, the different parts of the computer. So can anyone just tell me?
Only machine language.
Yes.
Ma'am, we understand only machine language, ma'am.
Yes, computer understand only the machine languages, that is, which is in the form of binary numbers, that is 0 and 1. Is it correct?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
So now, which all other parts are there in computer? Tell me some of the parts of computer. Yes. Yes, CPU. Then?
Keyboard.
Mouse. Then?
Monitor.
Yes. So, speaker. That is monitor, keyboard, CPU. These are the parts of your computer. So, in your computer, there are having some of the input devices, output devices, and storage devices. All of you know which all are the input devices. Can you tell me? Anyone? Yes?
Ma'am, keyboard.
Yes. Then? Tell me the names of input devices.
Then mouse, keyboard.
Okay. And which all are the output devices then? Okay. So there are input devices are there, output devices are there, and storage devices are there. To store the data, we have some of the storage devices like CD, DVD, pen drive. Okay. Okay. So in this lesson, we will going to learn different classifications of your computer languages. So before going to that, first I'll tell you computer system, it is considered and it is having two components. So which all are the two components? That is, one is the hardware and one more is the software. Okay, these are the two different components. That is, one is hardware and one more is software. So now, what is the meaning of hardware? Can anyone know what is the meaning of hardware component? Yes.
Ma'am, we can touch.
Yes. So you can touch some of the devices of computer. That is, you can touch monitor, you can touch mouse, keyboard, and CPU. And you can feel that comprises what it is. So whatever you can touch and you can feel, these all components are what? Hardware components. Understood all of you what is the meaning of hardware components? Okay. So whatever the components are there that you can touch and feel the components, that is called as what? Hardware components. Next comes what? Software. So what is the meaning of software now? It is the set of programs and related data that are used to give the instructions. Suppose there are some of the programming languages, that is C, C++, Java. These all some of the programming languages. This comes under what? Software. Okay. So these are the components of your computer system. That is, one is your hardware system that you can touch and feel the system components. That is, you can touch mouse, keyboard, then speaker, CPU. These you can touch and feel. These are your hardware components. But the components you can't touch and only you can execute that is your software systems. So all of you understood about what is the meaning of hardware components and what is the meaning of software components?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So now, next is the main topic is that is different classification of your computer language. So you all can see this screen?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So here in this, the classification of computer languages, there are two classifications in this. One is one is low level language and one more is high level language. So what is the meaning of this now? Low level language. Okay. So low level language in the sense what? Machine, you all know machine means computer understand only in the form of binary numbers, that is 0 and 1. Is it correct?
Yes,
ma'am. Okay. So these are what? Low level languages. That is low level languages what? Machine oriented languages. That is, these programming languages are designed for a particular computer architecture. It means what? It is machine oriented languages which machine understand. We don't want to convert once again that language into the machine level language. That is your low level language. So you all understood about what is the meaning of low level language? Any query in this? Okay.
Ma'am, can you repeat once again?
Okay. So you have two types of languages. Languages are classified into what? Two types. One is your low level language and one more is what? High level language. So what is the exact meaning of low level language? Low level language means what? It is machine oriented language. What is the meaning of this machine oriented language now? Which means, as you all know, computer understand only in the form of binary numbers, which is represented in the form of what? 0 and 1. I'll ask you one question. Why computer understand only in the form of zeros and ones? Anyone, can you answer me? Why computer understand only in the form of binary numbers 0 and 1? Why it doesn't understand any other languages? Can you tell me? Yes? Can anyone tell me? Why computer understand only in the form of 0 and 1? Why it doesn't understand any different languages? What is the definition of computer? Okay, I'll tell you. Computer understand only in the form of zeros and ones because computer is an what? Electronic machine. And it knows about only two states. So which all are the two states now here? One is on state and one more is off state. So whenever the on state is there, that is represented by 1. And off state is represented by what? 0. So only the computer understand in the form of 0 and 1. So the low level language is what? It is machine oriented language which it will understand. So you understood about the low level language now? Or again any doubt? Again any doubt? Okay. So in low level language, there are having two types. One is your machine language and one more is your assembly language. Okay. So in low level language, how many types are there? Two types are there. One is machine language and one more is assembly language. So now, what is the meaning of this machine language? As I told you, computer understand in the form of binary numbers, that is zeros and ones, that is on and off state. Okay. So whatever computer understand in the form of zeros and ones, that is your machine language. Here, we no need to convert the machine level language to any other languages to machine languages. whenever we will write, that time it will directly, automatically, it will understand this machine language, which is already in the form of 0 and 1. So it is machine language. So what is machine language now? Which is in the form of zeros and ones, which machine understand easily. That is your machine language. So you all understood about what is the meaning of machine language? What is the definition of machine language? Any doubt in this? Any doubt in this? Okay. So after machine language, second language is what? Assembly language. So what is the meaning of assembly language now? So here, assembly level language is not like a machine language, which is not in the form of what? Zeros and ones. Assembly level language is somehow different language. Like in this, as we learn in sixth standard, that is different commands. As you all know, we learn the different commands in your sixth standard. Can you tell me some of the different commands which we learn in sixth standard?
Ma'am, control plus S equal to save.
Okay, that is not a command. I'm asking which all are the commands we learn in sixth standard, which is in the form of abbreviated forms, which is abbreviated words. As in previous year, we learn about the different commands. If you want to print something, then which command we are using? We are using print command. If you want to add something, we are using ADD, add as a command. If you want to move something, that is by using MOV as a command. If you want to subtract, we are using SUB as a command. Yes or no? As we learn this all commands in your previous sixth standard. Yes? If you want to load something, we are using LD command. Yes? So like this, different commands are there. These commands are not in the form of binary numbers, that is, which is not in the form of what? Zeros and ones. So in assembly language, it is like a abbreviated words, that is, instructions are given in the form of what? Abbreviated words, which it is not in the form of zero and ones. In assembly language, the instructions are given in the form of what? Abbreviated words. For example, what it is? For example, add command, sum command, subtract command. Suppose if you want to, in computer language, suppose if you want to move something, that is, registers are there. Now you all know the different register, that is R0, R1, R2. These all are the different registers are there. So if you want to move that registers, then the command by using that command is called move command. We are moving that registers, that is R0 and R1. If you want to move, then by using move R0 comma R1. Okay, so we are using like this different commands, but computer directly doesn't understand how we can move. So for that, we have to convert this assembly level language to what? Machine level language, that is in the form of 0 and 1. So for that, we need assembler. So what is assembler now here? Which translates assembly level language to what? Machine level language. You're getting my point or no?
No, ma'am.
Okay, so you understood about what is the meaning of machine language?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so now next is, okay, so the next is what? Assembly language. Keep in mind, in assembly level language, the instructions are given in the form of what? Abbreviated words. What? Instructions are given in the form of what? Abbreviated words. For example, yes, we are writing the short form of what? Commands. That is, if you want to print something, we are writing the print as a command we are using. If you want to add something, sum command we are using. If you want to multiply something, multiplication, that is MUL as a command we are using. So we are using some of the commands to execute our program. That is your assembly language. Understood now?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So now in assembly level language, there is, now can you tell me if we write the print as a command, then also computer will not understand this print command, because you all know computer understand only in the form of zeros and ones. So now we have to convert this print to zeros and ones, yes or no? We have to convert this, yes, we have to convert from print to in the form of zero and one. So to convert this print from print to zeros and ones, there is one translator we are using, that is an assembler. Okay, so what is assembler now, which converts assembly level language to what? Machine level language. Assembler is what? Which converts assembly level language to machine level language is called as assembler. You all understood about what is an assembler and why by using the assembler now?
Yes, ma'am.
Anybody is having any doubt?
No, ma'am.
You can free to ask.
No, ma'am.
Yes,
ma'am. Yes, if you have any doubt, you can ask anytime. Any doubt you have? Yes?
No, ma'am.
Can I ask you the question now? Yes, can I ask you the question? Okay, so why we are using the assembler? Why we are using? Yes, why we are using the assembler? Because to convert assembly level language to machine level language. Then tell me, why we want to convert this assembly language? What is the necessity to convert assembly language?
Because
sometimes the computer
can't understand assembly.
Yes, why it doesn't understand assembly level language? What is the reason behind that?
Because it only understands
machine language. Yes, because computer understand only in the form of zeros and ones. So computer doesn't understand what? Assembly level language. So we need to convert this assembly level language to machine level language. So for that we are using what? Assembler.
Assembler.
Okay, you understood now? Any doubt till now? Okay, so one more question for you. What is the meaning of machine level language? The computer which understands in the form of zeros and ones, that is your machine language. So in assembly level language, yes? Yeah. So what is the meaning of assembler now? Okay. So assembler means what? Which converts. Okay. First I'll tell you. Yeah, it is one translator. Why it is a translator? Because in assembly level language, there is a commands are present. That commands computer will not understand easily. So inside of the computer, that commands it will converts into the machine level language. Because computer understand only in the form of zeros and ones. It will not understand which all other commands are there. If you type something or there, it will not understand anything. It will understand only which is in the form of zero and one. So because of that, in assembly level language, we are using a assembler. Understood now?
Yes, ma'am.
Or again, any doubt?
Yes, ma'am.
You all understood?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So now next is what?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so you understood about what is low level language?
Yes, ma'am.
So which all are the different categories of your low level languages?
Machine language.
Okay. So the next is what your high level languages. Okay. So now as we learn the low level language, next we are having the high level languages. So computer high level language also computer will not understand. It is in the form of English like words and mathematical symbols. Like it is like a coding languages like C++, Java. These are the different types of languages. The program is written in the form of different language. Okay, so computer will not understand high level language also. So to convert this high level language, we are using interpreter. Okay, so to translate this, again computer will not understand this high level language because computer understand only in the form of zero and ones. So in high level language, the program is it is written which is in the form of like a programs or how we can speak, or else it will be used for different mathematical symbols. So it will not understand that also. So for that reason, we are using in high level language interpreter, that is to convert high level language to what? Machine level language. Computer will not understand this high level language because for that reason we have to convert this again high level language to what? Machine level language. So for that reason we are going to use the interpreter. So you understood about high level language? Or confusion is there?
Yes,
you are having confusion?
No, ma'am.
Okay. So, in high level language, it is written in the form of what? English-like words and mathematical symbols. So, suppose if I'll tell you the different types of languages, if I'll tell you now that is C, C++, Java, Python and all, then you'll not understand this, what is the meaning of this. So, for that, I'll show here how that language is. Okay, just wait for 1 minute. I'll show you what is that language. So you all can see this word pad. You all can see this word pad. Okay, just wait for 1 minute, okay? Just wait for 1 minute, students.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. Ma'am.
Okay, just wait for 1 minute. So now you can see this. Now you can see this screen. Yes. Okay. So in this, I'll write here the high level language, which is in the form of C.
No, ma'am.
You all can
see.
Okay. Okay. It is a wide screen. I will start writing now. Okay, so see here, I'll write here. I'll increase the screen size.
Okay, so here I'll write hash include std.
Mom, log.
S.
Mom, please increase the size of.
S. I'll increase the size. Can you see this now?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
So, it is like a different programming language, that is hash include stdio.h. It is understanding to you. What is this?
No, ma'am.
Okay. Yes, who is telling us? Okay. So, this type of programming languages are there, that is hash include stdio.h. That is nothing but stdio means it is standard input output. Std means standard, I means input, O means output, H means what? Header files. So now here suppose if I want to add two things. Okay, so for that I'll use the programming language. If I want to add something, if I want to add the two numbers, that is 2 and 3. Okay, it will be written in the programming language like this. First, I return hash include stdio.h. Next, I'll write here hash include math.h. Why I'm using math.h? Because it is a, we are solving 2 plus 3. So, it is comes under maths. In mathematics, it will come. Yes or no? So,
yes, ma'am.
So, we are using maths as a programming language, yes, that is library. Next, we want to add two things, okay? That is 2 and 3. So, we are going to write the, that is, we are going to use printf, okay? Printf as a function, we are going to print that two numbers. So, we are going to write printf and enter two numbers. So, in enter two numbers, after that, enter two numbers means what? We have to enter two numbers in the output form, that is 2 and 3. So in scanf, we have to write scanf. In scanf, what you have to write? Just wait for 1 second. So in scanf, I'll write here percentage d, comma, two numbers. So this high level language is like this. Okay, suppose if you want to add the two numbers, then first we are going to write this standard input output dot h header file. Next we are going to write this maths library. Next, we want to enter two numbers. After that, the result will get print. So, for this is in the form of high-level language. So, this high-level language also, computer doesn't understand. We need to convert this into, that is, binary numbers, which is in the form of zeros and ones. Okay, so for that reason, if you want to translate that computer language to machine level language, we are going to use the that is interpreter. So we are using interpreter to convert this language to machine level language. So you all understood now?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Or
yes, ma'am.
Any doubt in this machine level language?
Yes, ma'am.
Any doubt in this machine level language?
Language,
it understand,
ma'am.
It is understand only in the form of zeros and ones, that is binary language, that is machine level language.
In high level language also, ma'am.
In high level language, it will understand, but that is we have to convert that high level language to again machine level language, because we know computer which understand only in the form of zeros and ones. But high level language, which I written the code now, that is not in the form of zeros and ones. It is in the forms of like programming languages. So that programming language also, it is like in the form of English words. As you saw math.h, as you saw the symbols, as you saw the hash include, enter two numbers. Does computer understand this? Enter two numbers. Can you just tell me?
No, ma'am.
It understand only in the form of zeros and ones. It will understand what is zero and what is one. So whatever one. That program I return, that program again it will convert that program to machine language, which is in the form of zero and one. So to convert that program into zero and one, we are using in high level language what? Interpreter. So what is interpreter now, which converts high level language to machine level language?
Machine language.
So you understood. If you have any doubt, you can ask me. I think you have the confusion. Yes. As you know, the computer understand which is in the form of binary numbers, that is in the form of zeros and ones. So computer understand only the machine language which is in the form of zeros and ones. So if it is yes, in ma'am. Other languages, we need to convert that language to machine level languages. So last 5 minutes I'll take and I'll ask you. Yes, last 5 minutes I'll take and I'll ask you a few questions. You just give the answers. Okay.
Yes,
okay, so till now we learn what is different hardware components and software components, then classification of computer languages. So which one are the classifications? Just tell me the classification of your computer languages. Yes.
Low level language.
Yes. So what is the meaning of low level language?
Machine-oriented language.
Yes, machine-oriented languages. Next, how many types are there in your low-level languages? Okay, so there are two types in low-level language. One is machine language and one more is assembly language. So what is the meaning of machine language? Okay, which computer understand which is in the form of binary numbers, that is 0 and 1. Yes, ask me.
Ma'am, in the lunch class, you will discuss all the question and answers or fill in the blank?
I'll tell you that in the next class, okay? I'll not give you any fill in the blanks, any question answers. You have to refer your textbook and you have to write yourself. Okay? Questions I'll give, you have to write that questions. Okay?
How will you understand?
Okay, ma'am.
You have to read the textbook. You have to read the textbook. Yes.
We'll correct the book.
Correcting the books and all afterwards I'll tell you. Don't worry. Okay? You just read the textbook. Yes. Yeah, how to write, when to write, when to start the writing in your book. I'll tell you that later. Okay. So I'll wind up this class now. In the next class, I'll start. First, I'll ask you the questions in the next class. So be prepared what I taught today. Okay.
Ma'am, 1:30.
Okay. Bye, ma'am. So I'll wind up the class, but you have to.